In today's video, we're going to be having a look at the latest announcement from Tuya. We're also going to be running through some troubleshooting for the new Tuya integration. And if you stick around till the end, I'm going to be showing you some new and upcoming features for the Tuya integration. Check it out. What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. If you didn't know, over the last few months, Tuya have been working on a brand new integration for Home Assistant known as Tuya V2. The integration's been receiving regular updates, and with each update, it's been gaining new features, new product support, and things like language localization. And if you're up to date with your Home Assistant news, then you'll know that in the latest 2021.10 update, the new Tuya integration was added into Home Assistant Core. Now, when this was done, the original Tuya integration was removed, so if you were using the old one, you would have had to move to this brand new one. This update made Tuya a breaking change, and the reason for this is just because it wasn't a direct upgrade from the original Tuya integration to the new one. The new integration is a brand new integration with a brand new code base, and it's based on Tuya's new open APIs. And with the new integration came a new set of instructions that you're going to need to follow in order to get the integration up and running. To help out with this, I have created a video on it, and you'll find a link to that above and also in the description. So if you want a bit of help with that, be sure to check out that video. Getting set up with the new Tuya integration hasn't been plain sailing for everybody, but I'm going to be going through some of the issues that I've been messaged about a lot and hopefully helping you to resolve them. So if you have had any of these issues, hopefully this helps. But before we get on with the core integration troubleshooting, let's just take a step back and come back to Tuya V2. So at the point of 2021.10 releasing, we had two different versions of the Tuya integration. We had the Tuya Core integration, which is the new official one, and then we had the Tuya V2 version, which was on HACS. So the official version, the version that's just been pulled into Home Assistant Core, this was created by the Tuya developers with the help of the Home Assistant developers. So it's been vetted by Home Assistant, and it meets and passes all the standards and needs that a core integration must have. We've then got Tuya V2, which can be found on the official Tuya GitHub page, and you can set it up and install it using the Home Assistant Community Store. This version is also created by the Tuya developers, but the code base isn't in line with Home Assistant standards, and it doesn't match and meet any of those standards needed for a core integration. Which is why we ended up with two different integrations, as V2 wasn't written or designed in a Home Assistant friendly way, so the integration that's been added to Home Assistant Core had to again be created from scratch. So based on that new integration for Home Assistant Core, Tuya began refactoring the code for V2 with what they'd learned, and that's what the 1.6 update mainly focused on. Tuya's initial idea was to just refactor the V2 integration so that it was more in line with the version that's in Core, that way any future improvements or changes would be more likely to just be accepted into Core. Tuya were going to carry on with the development of V2, so we would have had V2, which Tuya would have been committing and doing all the changes to, and then we would have had the core version, and then I guess Tuya would have just passed the stuff from the V2 version into core when it was ready to go. But that idea just didn't really work, as people would be making changes and updates and just fixing issues and just general problems with the version that's in core, and then the V2 version would be out of sync with this. And when I queried Tuya about this, I asked them if they'd be pulling changes and fixes from the version in core into V2. They actually said no. So again, this would also make the V2 version be out of sync with core. So as of today, the V2 version is no longer going to act as the beta, and it's also not going to be developed any further by the Tuya developers. So what this does now mean is that there's just going to be one version, which works out well because there's not going to be two different versions for people to get confused on. There's not going to be two versions to have to report issues on and just maintain and track. As of right now, the current V2 version currently supports more products and has a few more features than the official core version, but in the next update that should all change, and we'll be talking more about this in just a second. So in short, the V2 version is no more. If you're currently making use of the V2 version, I would highly recommend switching over to the core version, but I'd only do so when the 2021.11 update drops, just as it's going to contain those extra features that are missing. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, setting up and installing the new Tuya integration hasn't been plain sailing for everybody, so I'm just going to run through some of the common questions that I've been asked a lot in the comments or in messages, and hopefully it helps. Up first, we've got an issue where lights and switches are instantly turning back on or back off after being turned on or off. This issue is caused by the device status notification, which is step 6 if you're following along with the Tuya documentation. Now, I did try and highlight this in the video that I did. If you miss this step or forget to add that on, you'll find that when you're using the integration and you're controlling things like switches and light, when you're turning them on and off, you'll find it'll be a bit janky where you'll turn it on and it will instantly switch back on. Now, you may not have seen my video, or you may have just missed that step if you were watching along, but the device status notification is the likely culprit for this problem. So if you are having this issue, then you're going to want to go and check that you've authorized this API. Now, to actually do this, you don't need to create a new account. You can add it to an existing account. So if you did miss this step, you can just add it back on. So let's head over to the developer IoT platform now. Once you're on the developer platform, you're going to want to choose cloud and then development. And from here, we're going to want to select our cloud project that we created. So in my case here, it was Tuya V2. With your project selected, you're going to want to come to the top here and you're going to want to choose Service API. In my list here, I can see that I've got the device status notification already authorized. But if you didn't have this, you'd need to click this Go to Authorize in the top right. You'll then be presented with an authorization box, and in here you're going to want to just start typing device status notification. As you start typing that, you should see that appear and it should have a little blue subscribe next to it. So if you were to click that for the device status notification, it would add it to your list. You should then see the device status notification in your list and you should be good to go. All you'll now need to do is just head back into Home Assistant, give it a reboot, and then when you try toggling on and off those lights and switches, they should just go to the correct state and not instantly switch back. Another message I've had a lot is how do I go about setting up the trial account because it's now moved. So previously when setting up a cloud account, Tuya would require you to set up a trial account, and to do this you'd actually have to run through the whole process as if you were buying an account but you don't actually pay anything. But this process has now been streamlined and you don't actually have to set up a trial account, one's just applied by default, so you can just click to create a cloud project and you're good to go. Moving on, another error that I've had reported to me a lot is an error popping up when trying to actually add the new Tuya integration. So this error is a pop-up that says the config flow could not be loaded. So you'll see this message as a pop-up, and if you were to look in your logs, you'd also see a similar message. Now the reason this one happens is because you're installing Tuya whilst you've already got the Tuya V2 integration installed as well. A simple solution for this one is to just remove the Tuya V2 integration and restart Home Assistant. If you're still getting that error, also check your file editor and make sure that in your custom components that the Tuya V2 component is also removed. The next error is to do with Tuya's cloud cross-region limitation. So with this one, you'll see an error when you're trying to scan the QR code with your Tuya or Smart Life app. This error will occur if you're trying to add your Tuya or Smart Life devices that you've got registered to your account to an unsupported data center. So this probably means that you've set the data center wrong on your Tuya cloud project. If you are getting this error, I'll have some links in the description below where you can go and check out Tuya's official documentation to find out which regions you should be using. Up next, I've had a bunch of different messages with Tuya error codes, with the most popular error code being error 1004. I think this one's probably the most popular error because I think people are trying to sign into the integration using their developer account. So when you're setting up the integration, it's going to ask you for your account username and password. And for this, you need to make sure you're using your Tuya or Smart Life account and not the developer account. I have also received a few of the other error codes, but rather than run through them all, I'll just leave a link to the Home Assistant documentation, which explains each of the error codes and what you can do to solve them. Okay, so the last one I'm briefly going to touch on then is missing devices. And this is where your integration is just missing a few devices or all of them. Two of the common reasons that I've seen for this is that you're moving from the V2 integration to the core one. So currently the V2 integration has more devices supported. So when you're actually moving to core, you're actually losing those devices. So with this one, you'll probably just notice a few different devices missing. But if you notice that all of the devices are missing, then you've more than likely got the wrong data center chosen. If you're on the IoT platform and you've linked your Tuya or Smart Life account and you can't view any of your devices, then it means that your data center is set wrong. So once you change that there, the integration should start seeing those devices too. So I think all this talk about missing and unsupported devices segues us nicely onto our final section of the video, which is upcoming features. So this is the part of the video where I tell you that the Tuya integration has just been Francked. Just in case you didn't know who Frank was, Frank is one of the main Home Assistant developers and he literally contributes to all the various corners of Home Assistant. You probably also know Frank as the guy that has the mammoth task of collating all of the Home Assistant release notes. And if you catch any of the Home Assistant live events or release parties, then you will have definitely seen him. So for the last week and a bit, Frank's been doing a lot of work on the Tuya integration and he's implemented a whole bunch of things. Things like a working early build of the Tuya camera platform, which also includes doorbells. And yes, those doorbells have push notifications. And just to make you aware, this is an early prototype, but it's a massive step forward, and cameras and doorbells in the Tuya integration is something we've never had before. He's also been on a mass spree refactoring and rewriting the Tuya lights. He's added support for the highly requested dimmer switches, he's made a lot of the light code reusable, he's improved the colours, he's improved the temperature, he's added support for a whole bunch of different light categories, and all in all just overhauled the whole of the Tuya lights. And that's just a small fraction of the things that he's been working on. You'll find a whole bunch more, and you'll find all of these things in the Home Assistant 2021.11 update. Now, I'm not going to run through all these things, but if you are interested in knowing a bit more, I'll leave a link to Frank's Twitter in the description below, and I'll also leave a link to the Home Assistant Core Git repo, so you can go and check out the pull request for these things. Midway through the week, I did also get the chance to sit down and chat with Frank about Home Assistant, tech, Tuya, and some crazy conspiracy theories. Thank you again for that, Frank, and for all the work that you do, and not just on the Tuya integration, but on Home Assistant as a whole. If you've enjoyed this video and found it useful, then don't forget to drop me a like. And if you're not already, hit that subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell and you'll be alerted to any future video that I do. As always, a massive thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my patrons. If you're interested in supporting my channel and becoming one of these awesome dudes, then there'll be a link to my Patreon in the description below. So thank you for watching and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.